Okay, Stephen, you show him. You use your power in the media to try and get an absolute NBA great to the New York Knicks right now. For those of you who haven't heard, Stephen A. Smith says that Damian Lillard needs to leave Portland and should go to the New York Knicks. This is this is absolutely hilarious. I think this is pretty funny, but I also think, hold on, Stephen A. might be up to something here. He actually could be up to something in terms of the Portland Trailblazers. I just don't know. Like, I mean, we've seen so many places, like, there's so many teams that have really ended up competing. Like, again, not really big market teams, but I just don't know Damian Lillard on the Portland Trailblazers. They seem to be stuck in this cycle where they have this absolute great that really wants to be there, but they can't really, you know, get to the NBA Finals. And it just, I don't know, I feel like they're kind of wasting Damian Lillard's prime. And if they were able to get a crap ton of picks out of Damian Lillard, how insane would that actually be? I think that would be a really, really cool thing. Like, I mean, look, I know that it's just not going to happen, though. Like, let's be honest here. The Portland Trailblazers, they're not trading Damian Lillard unless he requests a trade. Damian Lillard does not want to leave Portland as well. It doesn't look like he's, like, the most loyal player in the NBA at this point. So it just doesn't seem like it really is going to happen at all. But let's just say in a theoretical world, in a theoretical situation, the Portland Trailblazers realize, hold on a second, we're kind of in a weird situation right now where maybe, you know, starting a rebuild and getting some good pieces out of the assets and players we have could actually be a pretty interesting stuff, you know, they could do. For example, they could literally trade CJ McCollum probably right now to the Bucks and get, you know, some players in like Dante DiVincenzo, etc., and a couple of first-round picks. I could realistically see that happening. While if we look at Damian Lillard, what would the New York Knicks have to offer up? In my opinion, the Knicks probably, out of all teams, have like some of the most assets to really give up. They currently sit in the 7th seed in the East right now, and I think they are really heading towards something. I believe that if they got Damian Lillard, they could try and sign another max star, and they could really compete. I honestly believe that they could nearly get to the finals with Damian Lillard and someone else on their team. Right now, they could, if let's just say they get Damian Lillard and they go out in free agency, and I don't know who they would necessarily get. I think there's a lot of free agents aren't exactly, you know, there's not exactly too many real big name free agents, you know, that are really coming up. But again, Damian Lillard and Julius Randle, that would actually be a pretty good, you know, duo right there. I'm not going to lie on that. I think that would actually be pretty good if we do look at it. Also, another player that the New York Knicks have been strongly linked to that I think they could get is actually Andre Drummond. There's a rumor they're going to make a trade for him, trade some bad contracts up here and there, and then they're going to bring him back in free agency for like really cheap. There was a rumor, you know, because he's from New York and he wants to play for a contender, he could take a discount. We've seen Blake Griffin go on for like $1 million. I honestly believe that, yeah, you could definitely see Andre Drummond go for like $5 to $10 million. Like, he's not worth that much in the league anymore. So again, he's another guy who I think they could get in right there. In my opinion, you know, Kawhi Leonard, if he declines his player option, I believe he could be a free agent. That's probably not going to happen. So if they really want to go for any big free agents, you know, to put with Damian Lillard, they're probably going to have to wait till 2022, where I believe James Harden, he'll have a player option, Kevin Durant as well, Russell Westbrook, John Wall, Bradley Beal would be, that's the player who I think they could definitely go out and get. Imagine that. So let's just say 2021, I'd say what they would have to trade for to get Damian Lillard. Let's just say if Damian Lillard, of course, the Trailblazers won the trading, which, again, this is not going to happen. This is just a theoretical world and a theoretical situation. We could be looking at a trade that I think would look like Emmanuel Quickley would have to be in the deal because of his potential. I think it'd be Emmanuel Quickley, Mitch Robinson, Kevin Knox, and Obi Toppin. Four really good young players that I think would all be in the rotation at, of course, Portland. Again, Emmanuel Quickley has a lot of trade value just in general. Really good young players. Same with Mitch Robinson. Obi Toppin still has some potential in the league, while Kevin Knox I'm not exactly too sure about. You throw in those four players, and considering James Harden was four future first round picks and four pick swaps, what I think it'd be, I think it'd probably be about three future first round picks. I'd probably say it'd be two unprotected New York picks and that unprotected Dallas pick. And then I think there'd be three pick swaps thrown in, plus those four really good players. Because, of course, Emmanuel Quickley, he's like a top 10 rookie in the league right now. Mitch Robinson's a very good young center. Obi Toppin as well just came off being pick eight, and when given a chance, can be a good player in the league. And Kevin Knox as well is still a very nice player, in my opinion. I'd say that is what you'd probably get. You know, again, it'd probably be a couple first-round picks less than, obviously, what James Harden would be. But that's just the type of situation, I think. Because I don't think Damian Lillard is as good as James Harden, so I'm probably going to say that. That's what I kind of stand by. Then, I think, you know, once you have that whole entire deal done, they literally have so much cap on this team right now. Like, there's no... There is heaps of room to move. They could literally, you know, just get Andre Drummond. They wouldn't even have to trade up any bad contracts. There's no bad contracts in this team, and they have heaps of cap to go out and spend. So again, they could probably just trade for him and trade up a player and a second round pick or something like that. Bring him back in free agency. Then you'd be looking at rolling through the 2022 season with starting five of Damian Lillard at point guard. I'd say, yeah, I think Emmanuel Quickley, I think he might start eventually. Yeah, you'd probably go, yeah, Emmanuel Quickley at shooting guard, RJ Barrett at small forward, Julius Randle at power forward, Andre Drummond at center. Then off the bench, you'd have like Alec Burks, Reggie Bullock, Austin Rivers if they keep him, Nerlens Noel, Frank Ntilikina, Derrick Rose, and whoever else they go get in free agency. Then I think in 2022, you do a sign and trade to try and get Bradley Beal to the team. That would be absolutely insane. Then imagine that team. You look at it, Damian Lillard at point guard, Bradley Beal at shooting guard, RJ Barrett at small forward, Julius Randle at power forward, Andre Drummond at center with Derrick Rose, Emmanuel Quickley, Alec Burks, Nerlens Noel maybe, whoever else they go get in free agency. That would be an absolute fantastic team, I'm not going to lie. So that would be pretty interesting, but of course it's all in a theoretical world and none of this is ever going to happen most likely. I think Damian Lillard is there to stay as a Portland player, and I think he'll most likely be there till nearly when he retires. I can't see him leaving. I think they're going to make the strongest push they can to get him some players. I wouldn't be surprised if they tried to get Kevin Love, etc. I think it's going to be pretty interesting, but of course it's going to be really, really, I don't know what's going to happen. I think Stephen A. Smith just wants him to go to the New York Knicks because he's of course a New York Knicks fan. But of course, I'd very much like to hear all of your thoughts and opinions on this down below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for all the latest NBA news and NBA content. Do you guys think that Damian Lillard should, of course, you know, potentially request a trade or something like that? Do you guys think he's happy on the Portland Trailblazers? What do you guys think is all going to be, of course, happening? Again, I'd definitely really like to know all your thoughts and opinions on this down below. But of course, don't forget to subscribe to my gaming channel, MIRL/LongChannels. Don't forget to check out my podcast as well, if you haven't already. Links for them will all be in the description down below. But as I was saying, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.